introduced only during the city's annual budget process.
Thank you. Is there anyone here to please give her? Man, it looks like you got the short straw.
The driver behind this paper is really to protect the budget. If during the year, after the budget's been voted on, passed, and balanced, hopefully in the reverse order, if a paper comes forward that takes away some revenue, then we got an unbalanced budget. So the purpose for the paper is simply to have the timing of any change like that to come at such time it can be accounted for in the budget and we end up with a balanced budget, and that's not a good thing. Pretty straightforward.
So it would, any time a person wanted to introduce a paper that had the revenue implication, then that paper could be passed, but we have to have the July 1st or so year that we vote.
That's a total list.
I actually really like this paper. I have a certain responsibility on those who draft the budget to hold the budget to the standards that we drafted, so that during the midterm and later parts of the year, we're not just wanting to start with the manipulator, because it has ripple effects throughout the entire city. And so I think this is a good proposal. I'd be willing to be a good paper.
And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to.
I like to ask a question better.
All right.
My question is, I need some clarification. My understanding is that once we adopt the budget goes into effect July 1st. There cannot be any amendments made to the budget except by mayor. So, in order for us to find revenue for a paper that we put in, I think the challenge is many papers that we put in, we always do a fiscal impact analysis as relates to that paper. And so, many of the papers that we put in, there's a fiscal impact, and that fiscal impact may simply be the number of hours the staff has to put on that particular job, and it comes up to, $2,000, $5,000, whatever. But my understanding is council does not have the capacity to put in a budget amendment. Only the mayor has the authority to do that.
I believe.
If I'm understanding this paper correct, that any paper that is put in during the course of once we adopt the budget, and there is a revenue, there's an expense that is not covered, or a revenue, a reduction in revenue, because the paper reduces revenue, maybe I'm confusing expenditures and revenue, and maybe it only refers to a paper that says, we're going to, as a paper that Mr. Sanders just put in. That paper read that we want to eliminate people taxes for any businesses that are currently less than 2 years in the city of Richmond, and we've already counted on those as revenues in the budget that we adopt, then he would have to find that revenue shortfall in the budget. But he can find, but he cannot amend, the council cannot amend, without the mayor's action introducing the amendment.
I believe you're right. I'd ask to be confirmed on that, but I believe you're right.
So then my second part to that question, whereas I see the merits of that, I think, but we're not in a position to address the problem that this paper tells us that we've got to do. We've got to find the money. We could find the money. We could say we want to amend the budget that says $100,000 for people. And we'll take $100,000 out of wherever. It may be acceptable. But we don't have the authority to do that. So this paper, I is not enforceable by the council because we do not have the power to make budget amendments. That's my first question. Make sure that we're clear. Secondly, I'm concerned about the expenditure part. Like if there's a paper that has a fiscal impact and creates an expense, is this paper also saying no deal unless you find the revenue to cover that expense?
That was our intent with the paper.
That's a good point, and I'm sorry to interrupt you. And I read the description of it. It speaks of proposals that would take, would cost money, would have fiscal impact. But if you read the resolution, it's all about reducing the revenue, not in terms of the food of paper and then has a fiscal impact of $50,000. This has, and maybe not all of this, is all deals with reduction of an existing revenue source, which is different.
I will tell you, it was there probably been others, but the most recent paper that brought to our attention we needed something like this is the paper we just spoke to. If you had a paper like that introduced that did get passed during the year, it would make the balance, the budget unbalanced.
And I appreciate that. But unless I'm not reading this paper correctly, and I would like to be sure that I understand exactly what this paper was saying, and I knew that this paper was directly in relationship to, because at the introduction of this paper, it was not with the idea that it would not go into effect until the new budget year. So by moving the date of it going into effect to July 1st, it gives us an opportunity to adequately project that reduction in revenue as part of our revenue projections. We will reduce that revenue projection by that now the anticipation of the legislation that we pass is going to have an impact on your revenue projections. My question is, whereas I understand that to be the case, because we do not have the option, as with Mr. Samuels, if he wanted to put this paper in today, and the council has the authority to amend the budget, council could have made a decision to pass this paper effective January whatever, and also an amendment to cover the anticipated revenue shortfall. But because we don't have the power to make that amendment, we really basically saying we can't introduce any papers of this sort unless the mayor is in partnership with us for the amendment, because we really don't have the authority to do that. And I am not sure that if we introduced a paper and it had a fiscal impact that was significant, that the administration would say, sorry, can't do this unless you find the money in the budget to cover the fiscal impact. According to this resolution that you've got. And I just want to make sure that we understand. If I'm incorrect, I'd like to be correct.
You may very well be correct. And it sounds like maybe we need a bit more time to vet through the issues you just brought up.
Maybe I can help you, Mr. Massacre. The way I understand the paper is that the timing of all these go into effect with the annual budget process, so that there's no need to worry about the amending of the budget, because the papers get introduced at the start of that budget cycle. So just as Mr. Samuels' paper he was introducing today was for the start date of July 1st, 2013, and just as we're hearing on utility bills, their implementation of the combined bill will be July 1st, 2013, because they've already budgeted. What they're trying not to do is have a treaty budget. throughout the year.
And I appreciate what you're saying, and I think that, but I think council needs to know that, because basically what you're saying, what this paper says to us, you have one opportunity to make a decision on this budget. During the budget cycle, right now, as we just did Monday, we introduced several budget requests, amendments, or amendments for the new budget that's coming up, okay? That will be considered. This paper here that we just passed, what this paper that we just did with Mr. Samuels does is in counteraction to any paper. Let me use for example. I want to put $2 million in a project in my district tomorrow. Okay? Instead of me waiting for a recommendation for a budget for the next upcoming fiscal budget, I'm going to do what Mr. Samuels did. I'm going to put an ordinance in with the $2 million for my project and get the mayor to approve it and get council members to vote in support of it. So when it comes to budget amendments, that paper would have already been adopted outside of the budget cycle and will already be factored in as that $2 million for the budget that would be considered. And you may be sitting down doing that.
Okay, I'm going to step this one step. We have a lawyer here. We probably had the very person who wrote this. So Ms. Roberts is. The way I read this deals with the revenue source. If we're going to reduce the revenue source, like if you call, or like now, all nonprofits can be non-exempt. Ms. Robertson's fear is that that will take away the ability that we have. We have lots of papers. We have fiscal impact of 30,000, fiscal impact of 80,000. Was in here, applying to here, which would be, could you give us your legal thing?
Well, to reiterate from the city attorney's office, fortunately, I wasn't the one who drafted this paper.
That's no
But it's my understanding that Ms. Robson is correct. The mayor has to propose or make recommendations for the new budget amendments. For example, Mr. Samuels, or President Samuels' paper, technically would not be considered a budget amendment. So obviously he could make or introduce that paper to change the code to provide for a program that would benefit new businesses in the city. Again, this is a resolution, which means it does not have the impact of law, which means if someone were to stray away from what is recommended in the resolution or proposed in the resolution, it would not be a violation of the law of any kind. I think this resolution is aspirational in nature, which means that this is something that the council and the mayor perhaps will work towards in the future or try to adhere to as much as possible. So with that in mind, the obviously if there are issues that arise, if the council or the council member wants to propose a change to the budget, obviously they would still need to get the mayor's recommendation. And the paper need to be supported by the council in order to pass. But in terms of code amendments and programs and things like that might ultimately impact a revenue source, I think those could still be proposed. However, because if the council is in agreement that the resolution should be followed, that council member recognizing that the program that they're supporting or that they want to endorse a code amendment for would need to also, that they would also need to identify another source for that revenue. So I think the way it would play out is if you have a code, if you have a budget amendment, you would need the support of the mayor to do that because the charter allows you to do that. If you want to propose a program that would reduce a revenue source, you would need to identify an additional source for that revenue. And about the budget, these proposed reductions being done during the time of the budget. Again, like I said, that's aspirational. It's not required by the charter. It seems to me that what the resolution is asking the council to do is to make those recommendations during the time of the budget. And that was, I think that would have, if the council wanted to adhere to that, that would limit it to that time frame, I believe. However, I can certainly look into it a little further to see if we talk with Mr. Lassiter to determine if that's what was intended or that's the game plan based on this resolution.
Yeah, I think since you and Mr. Lassiter were here during this conversation, that would probably be an excellent idea for administration to be able to answer some of these questions. Is anyone here to speak in favor of the opposition? Yes. Okay. Sir.
Good afternoon. Michael Gilbert, I want to be clear that I'm going to speak neutrally and as a private citizen on this. And just the point I was going to make is that, for instance, with Mr. Samuel's paper, if we say that there may be a reduction in projected future revenues from people. Well, the point of creating an incentive and what ECD, when they vet the incentives and put it in the ROI calculator, is yes, we might lose funds from people, but hey, we're gaining so much more because we're creating jobs, we're getting revenue from meals tax from those new jobs in the city, and that basically it would be a net gain for the city. So in that sense, if it was a revenue constraint, I don't think ECD or anyone else would propose creating an incentive program that the city wouldn't be gaining in the long run, if that makes sense. So I don't know that, just specifically in regards to Mr. Samuel's paper, yes, it might be lead to a reduction in projected revenues as a result of a lower people collection. However, once you adjust that, oh, there's these new businesses, new jobs, and new other revenues as a result of increased disposable income, that would be greater than, and therefore have an increase on the net of future revenue projections. And so I just want to make sure that we consider that type of effect, because I'm trying to be charitable here to ECD. I give them credit where I don't think they would propose an ROI when the city loses out in the long run. So just kind of a neutral comment as a private citizen. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, any other discussion on this paper?
I respect what this paper, the spirit of this paper, and what this paper is trying to accomplish. And I think that administration is saying, I do think this paper came about and changes were made. We thought that we started the implementation date July, with the July 2013-14 budget because of that, because it was seen as changing the revenue projections. And I think that's fine, but we're not talking about Mrs. Sanders' paper. We're talking about any papers that come up from council. If the administration decides that they want to find $50 million in the budget because they want to do a rescue deal, they can go into the budget, and they can find money in each pocket they need to, and they can make a recommendation to us to transfer money from this account to that account, to this account, to make a deal work. Okay? And they do that. And they can do that within the course of the budget year. They don't have to wait until the beginning of the next budget. If I wanted to have a great deal as well come to council, so I had a great deal of opportunity, and it would require us to do budget amendments. We have a tree out there we can pull money off of. We can only pull money from sources that are already in the budget. then we would not be able to do that in and of ourselves because we don't have the power to make those kinds of amendments. We would only be putting in budget requests, putting in a paper. And this is special because it's a color issue with the newspapers. Most papers would not be dealing with color. It would be dealing with special projects that we want to see happen. We would not be able to make this amendment. We would actually be putting in a pre-amendment if, and I don't know if this paper conditioned itself to say that you can't, if you file the amendment, when you put it in and you can adopt it with the understanding that it only goes into effect at the beginning of the budget year. And I'm just concerned that we may be setting ourselves up for a whole lot of pre-budget papers for amendments for approval prior to the budget cycle. If we know that, you know, we can get them in early, adopt them, we got a spaceholder for the upcoming budget. Because that's when new revenues will be brought to the table. I'm not in opposition. I understand the administration's position.
Well, it says, whereas, council and mayor will be displeased type of alternative revenue source to offset each proposed reduction of an existing revenue source. Only adopt those reductions in existing revenue sources. And then it goes down the next whereas. The page number proposal that would result from the reduction of an existing revenue source must identify an alternative revenue source. The way that I read this paper, it refers to an existing reduction in existing revenue source.
That is true, but I think the explanation that Mr. Agalesto gave was spot on. As far as the intent of the paper, I know that in finance we get every paper to look at, and we look at the fiscal impact. And we're well aware when we read many of those papers that a thorough analysis has not been done. Often it's exactly what we're talking about, and we send them back to the patient to have them reconsider. So you were spot on in what you said at the intent.
And actually, I think we did do it when we did the moratorium on the tax exemption. Mr. Hester was born this year. I don't think we did that. No, we don't think it's in the field. Other discussion on this paper? Need a motion?
I move to send this to full council with the approval of this committee.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
Thanks. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposition?
Abstain?
Thank you.